everyone, I'm back with another Teach Me How to YouTube. Today I'm going to be talking about all of your technical stuff, and I'm basically just going to give you a few things that will help you greatly to improve your YouTube videos and the quality of your YouTube videos. And I will have more details on my blog, so make sure to head on over to that post if you're interested in really getting in depth with this topic, because I'll just kind of be touching over the basics here. And then I'm also going to show you guys my filming setup. It's not the greatest, it's not amazing, but a lot of you guys have asked about it, and I think it'll help kind of pull everything all together, everything that I'm saying. So, first tip for improving your YouTube videos is lighting. You guys probably hear this all the time in all of these videos, but it is so true, and I still see people using lighting improperly. I still have a hard time lighting my videos because lighting is so dependent on so many factors. It depends on your camera. It depends on your physical like lights. If you have studio lights, it depends on your ceiling lights. It depends on the windows and the, you know, everything that's going on outside. Even if your windows are closed, you're still gonna have a different lighting depending on time of day and things like that. First thing that I try to do, I really try to film during the day. And this is hard for me because I'm a night owl. I feel drowsy around this time. It's like almost, or it's 5 o'clock right now. It's still sunny, but I feel like I want to take a nap at this time of the day. I get my second wind at 8 o'clock at night, but I have to push myself to film, you know, before 6 o'clock, or else the lighting is just going to be completely different. And you can notice in some of my videos when I'm filming at night and using completely artificial light and when I'm using a combination. So try to film when there's some kind of sunlight out, if at all possible. Next thing, obviously, use that sunlight. Sit as close to a window as you can. Well, I take that back. Don't sit as close to a window as you can, because again, that really depends. I see people who are literally like their camera's in their window and it's just like beaming on them, and that doesn't really look good either. If you guys watch my vlogs, you know like how my setup is and everything like that, but I sit, you know, a couple of feet away from my window, and I sit a little bit at an angle to it. Ideally, I would be facing exactly directly towards the window because the light is going to hit my face evenly that way. But because of my background and how my room is set up, I don't like how that looks. So I sit a little bit at an angle. Now, since I'm sitting a little bit at an angle, that's where my lights come into play, because you want to make it look as even as possible. So this side of my face is going to be really illuminated by the sun, but then what about this side of my face? You know, and you can kind of see how this is a little bit more in the shadows still, but I use an umbrella light, and then I also use a standing kind of, I don't know what you call these lights. It's a light. I bought it at Walmart. It's like actually supposed to be used as a lamp for like a living room or something like that. And I actually inserted a regular bulb, a regular light bulb. It's not a studio light bulb. And it is the natural daylight kind, I believe. Because a little something that people don't ever talk about in these videos that I'm surprised is studio lights, the bright white lights, are not made for people who have skin like mine. FYI. This is actually something, totally random side note, but I actually learned this on Oprah. She was talking about it one time, about her set and how it's not made for people of color because it washes them out. Traditional studio lights are not made for people of color. You really need to customize it. And that's not just to say people of color. I mean, you need to customize it anyway, but especially if you have darker skin, bright white studio lights will wash you out. And again, I have videos, I have examples. I will show you guys if you guys want examples of that, where I am just completely washed out and I look gray. So I try my best to really make my skin look like the real color that it is. And I think I've gotten better and better. Another thing that's really helped me is I painted my walls white, because for some reason, when they were like that weird beige color, it really threw things off, and I think the white kind of helps my brown tan skin stand out and like bounce off and kind of get the light better. So those are just a few things. The last thing that I'll talk about for lighting is actually paying attention to your camera settings, because you can't just turn on a camera, no matter how good it is, and expect it to be amazing, you know, light quality. A lot of these really good high-end cameras work very well in low light, but you have to learn how to do it. You're gonna need to white balance your camera. That's the first thing. Manually white balance your camera. I can't say that enough times, because the look of it is just gonna be so much better, I'm telling you. And play around with your ISO and your aperture. And I'm not gonna go into those too much because that's getting way too technical, but that does carry me to my next tip, which is use your camera properly. And I know that it's really tempting to just go out and buy the most expensive camera and the one that everybody uses, which is what, like the Canon Rebel, the T3i, T4i. Everybody on YouTube uses those. They're great cameras. I would love to have one of those cameras. They're amazing, but you would be really surprised about what you can actually do with a different camera if you just know how to use it properly. I've seen people use really, really cheap cameras and have amazing quality. I've seen people use really, really expensive cameras, like the, 60D, 60, I don't even know, and their quality looks like crap. So I really recommend reading your camera manual, doing as much research online as you can. YouTube has great tutorials. The internet is a big, wonderful place. So really spend some time getting to know your camera and spend some time taking photos and learning how to take video of other people. That's helped me so much. I am a film studies major, so I do production on the side, and you know, I have to do production and I have to film other people. So I do have to say that is very helpful. So if you have a friend who might be, you know, I don't know, an aspiring model or actress or something like that, volunteer some of your time to kind of get to know the camera, because it's a lot easier to learn the settings when you're behind the camera instead of when you're in front of the camera, if that makes any kind of sense. So really play around with your camera. You don't have to buy the most expensive camera in the world. You really, really don't. What I use is the Panasonic Lumix GMC5, and it's an older style of the Lumix. It's not super old though. It's like fairly, I don't know, maybe 2000, maybe it's a couple years old, a few years old, I don't know. But it is a great camera. It's a mirrorless Micro Four Thirds, which basically is like a DSLR, but it's a lot more compact, and there's a lot of technical stuff to go into it, but that's basically all that I'm gonna say about that so it doesn't get confusing. And yeah, it gives off great quality, but it doesn't give off great quality if I don't put the work in to get that good quality, if that makes sense. So don't buy the most expensive camera, do your research and read that camera manual, no matter how daunting and big that it is. Next tip is try to make your background look somewhat nice. I struggled with this for a long time too. I think everybody does. And you know, it really adds to your videos to have something that looks a little interesting in the back. It doesn't mean it has to look like, you know, a freaking mansion in the background, but just try to keep that corner that you film in tidy and clean, and you know, put up some fake black roses if you're feeling a little witchy. Burn a little candle, you know, try to put out maybe some of your prettiest perfume bottles if you do beauty stuff. You know, just kind of keep it nice and keep it consistent. I think that that really does have an effect. I get compliments on my background a lot, and I don't think it's anything special or anything interesting, but I think that why I get compliments on it is because people are used to it, and people equate my background with my videos, and so, you know, it's just kind of like coming home, if you know what I mean. Like, that's why you keep your house nice, is because you want it to have a certain feel. So you want your videos to feel the same way for your viewers. And I want you guys to feel like you guys are coming into my little beauty corner, my little goth dungeon beauty corner with me. And I think that you guys feel that way. So I hope you do. So just try to keep it nice. Try to keep it clean. You guys, if you were to see the rest of this room, if you guys watch my vlogs, again, you know this is like a jungle in here. But as long as you can keep that little corner nice, and again, I painted my walls white because I thought it looked better. I thought it looked nice contrasting with all the black and blah, blah, blah. Next tip is use a microphone. And I do not do this ever. I have one. I have one that gives off great quality sound. There's a couple videos that I used it in. I'll try to find those and link them for examples for you guys. But yeah, I'm really bad at doing that. I'll admit it. One thing about the Lumix that I don't like is that you cannot connect a microphone to the Lumix. So I have to record audio separately and then combine them in the editing process. And that just adds a lot of time when it's just unnecessary. So I don't use a microphone. I do plan on upgrading my camera at some point. Again, it's not something urgent, but at some point I will upgrade my camera, and then I'll probably just buy a mic that I can connect right to my camera. But that is one thing that I think makes such a huge difference, because think about somebody who, you know, you turn on their YouTube video and it's like, "Hey guys, it's LJ, welcome back to my channel, I hope you guys..." Nobody wants to listen to that. Think about that compared to, "Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, this is LJ." Okay, that was actually really annoying, but you know what I mean. If you can hear the person, they're audible, they're clear, they're concise, you're more likely to stick around. So make your videos be that way too. And a microphone really helps. It also helps with the little background noise, you know, that little annoying buzzing, like if you guys just stop and listen to it right now, you'll hear that, like, I don't know what it is. If it's a fan, air conditioner, if it's just the way my camera sounds, you can hear it though. And you don't notice it, but in playback, it really is noticeable. So having a microphone kind of helps get rid of some of that. The last tip that I have is watch your freaking videos. I'm telling you, I cannot tell you how many times I've been watching a video. I'm like, they really didn't catch that blooper. You know, they didn't think to edit that out. They didn't realize they spelled that wrong. Just so many random like errors that are unnecessary. I mean, I get it. Nobody's perfect. I have tons of errors. Nobody's perfect. But I think that the more that you watch your videos, the better you're going to be at editing yourself. I know that the biggest thing, the biggest problem that I have in filming myself is I say like every other word, and like too. So because I watch my videos and I know that I do that, when I go into edit, I'm prepared for that. I know how to mask those. I know, you know, how to take those out, how to blur them, whatever. You also start to learn what people are responding to and kind of get to know some viewer trends. You get to learn what people like and what people don't like. And it's just really helpful so you don't repeat yourself. I've seen beauty gurus review products, say they love them, and then try them like 6 months later and say they've never tried it. It's like, I'm not saying that they're lying, but it's like, you don't remember that. So watching your videos will just kind of help like bring that stuff to mind and keep your facts straight and keep everything together. And, you know, I'm not saying to watch your videos obsessively, but every once in a while, I'll go back and watch an old video. One, because it's super funny too, because it is just hilarious to watch your old videos, but you can really see how much you've improved and what you still need to improve on and all of that kind of stuff. So I really, really recommend doing that. So I'm gonna talk just for a couple minutes about my filming setup. I already talked about my camera. I use a Panasonic Lumix GMC3, wait, what? Panasonic Lumix GMC5? I don't know if that's right. I'm gonna have it listed below. And I actually just use the kit lens for filming my videos. I do have another lens, which I'm gonna list down below which one it is. It gives off amazing quality. It's the only other lens that I have for this camera, but it is a telephoto lens, which means it can zoom in, you know, really far. And so that's another thing that I didn't touch on, but lenses do make such a difference in your quality. So going along with using your camera properly, make sure that you're, you know, investing in lenses. If you really want that depth of field, if you really want that autofocus, you know what you're looking for, know what your camera's weaknesses are so that you know what kind of lens to look for, blah, blah, blah. But anyway, I basically just use a kit lens usually just because it's fine for this. But if I go out and I do lookbooks and things like that, I usually do use a different lens just because I think it looks a little bit better in outside and things like that. I don't know. You just have to play around with it. So that's what I use. This tripod is actually quite an annoying tripod, I must say. Again, something that I'm going to upgrade eventually, but no rush. I'm actually really lucky because I can borrow my school's anytime that I want, so I use that a lot of the times. It's much better quality. But this one was just purchased on Amazon, and it does the job. You know, it's nothing great. I definitely wouldn't recommend it if you go traveling on shoots a lot, if you do a lot of like, you know, filming other people and filming outside and things like that. But this pretty much just stays right here in this place, so there's not a lot of wear and tear done on it, so it's fine. This light is from Walmart. This is the one that I was talking about. It's just a little stand lamp, and I did put that natural daylight bulb in there. I use this and I could just kind of bounce it off of like my head a little bit because I like the, I wouldn't say halo effect because that is something that's a term in lighting, in film, in photo. That's not what this is, but I do just kind of like how it kind of, I don't even know. I just like how it looks, just kind of bouncing off my head and kind of illuminate the top of my head because the way the window is, it just kind of goes right down on my face as opposed to my head. Does any of that make sense? I don't know. This over here is an umbrella light by Lomos Studio. I bought it on Amazon. It came in a set of three, I believe. Came with that stand and everything, which is really nice. The bulb, the umbrella, everything. I think the kit was like $40 or $50. I'll have it listed down below because it's an amazing starter set. Again, this is nothing that I use on shoots, on real shoots for my film projects and things like that because it's just not the greatest quality. But for sitting right here in my room, staying in that same place. It's lasted, you know, over a year. It's fine. It's fine. That is the light that it comes with. I'm not exactly sure what the wattage is on it, but hopefully I'll be showing it right here, or I'll have it listed down below. But it is pretty bright. For a while, I was using like two of these at once, and you could tell. It's like, that's what I was talking about when I said that it washed out my dark skin, because it's just like, that is way too bright. And then it had the window open too. So I do not have that facing me directly. It's facing this kind of back area, so it illuminates this wall behind me, or where am I pointing? Like this wall area behind me, and then it does kind of light up a little bit of this side of my face since I have the window here, but it is not directly facing me. The bulb itself is actually facing backwards too, because if I face it forwards, it is so bright. So I'm just gonna turn off my lights really quickly and show you guys what my setup would look like if I didn't have any lights at all, so you can kind of compare. Okay, so this is what my lighting looks like. Oh my gosh, I look like a different person. This is crazy. This is what my lighting looks like just sitting in front of the window. You can see how shadowy it is, how much lighter everything looks. I look very just not very illuminated. It looks very sad. So I definitely recommend using some kind of lighting, even if you sit in front of a window, unless you have a great window. I've seen some people who have like those huge, like, oh, like sliding glass doors and stuff like that are perfect. I had a sliding glass door in my old apartment, and I would film in front of that a lot because it got so much light. So back to normal. This is what I'm used to filming with. And yeah, I hope this video was helpful for you guys. I know that some of you guys weren't into this series, the last video that I posted, and I got all mad about it, but I don't really care because this is what I want to post. And a lot of you guys are very grateful for me putting up the video and thought it was interesting and thought it was fun. I'm not trying to be know-it-all-ish or anything like that. I'm just trying to share what I know, because we all have something to offer and we all have something to teach each other. I'm open to learning. I'm open to teaching, you know? So let's just all be nice here. And yeah, I hope this is helpful for you guys again. Just make sure to check out the blog post if you're interested in more specifics. I'll try to have all the products, or you know, all the stuff that I talked about in this video listed down below. So anyway, I'll talk to you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Bye. In general, if you're not into leather jackets, you know, it could be like whatever, some other material. There are plenty of cute jackets. I personally am a leather girl, or a pleather girl, be kind to the animals, actually. And so I just have this leather jacket. I'll show a better clip of it than me just holding it up like this. But it's just a plain leather pleather jacket.